So object, last class we covered class, class example and definition of the object, and again in this lecture we are going to talk about object, example for object, what is the relation between object and class, how to declare an object in a programming. We'll see everything clearly. Here object is an instance of a class. An object is a class variable. It can be uniquely identified by its name. What is the meaning of instance of a class? Nothing but when the class is created, automatically we will create the object also. That's why the instance of the class. So automatically we create the object for the class. Next one, that object become a variable for that particular class. So object behaves like a variable also, and it has a unique identity by its name. It's a unique identity. So because we can create many objects, as many as we want, so many objects we can create in a particular class. So that's why each object is maintaining its identity. It is a unique identity by its name. So for example, many pens are there, black pen, red pen. So black pen is one identity, red pen is one identity, and green pen is one identity, brown, like that. So these all are objects, but each object it has its own identity. The same manner in programming language also. So each object uniquely identified by its name. And next, every object have a state which is represented by the value of its attributes. The state are changed by the function which applied on the object. So last class we discussed the object, it contains state as well as behavior. Every object it contains state as well as object. What state says, what behavior says. For example, take a car as example, car color, car price, car logo, car company. These all are state of the car. What is the behavior of the car? The behavior of the car, moving, applying gears, steering. These are the behavior. So like that, every object it will maintain one state, the second one is behavior. So now we will see how you create an object in a programming language, especially in a class. What is the relation between class and object? Object contains identity, behavior, and state. What is the identity? The identity is nothing but the name, a number, like this, to identifying of the person, identifying of any object. Behavior, that particular object, what it will do, the functionality called behavior, functioning, working, doing of work. This is called a behavior of that object. And second one is the state. State is nothing but referred by data stored within the object and any time moment. So every object contains identity, behavior, and state. How you creating an object? How you create an object in a class? Okay, till now we have seen the definition of the class and definition of the object and the attributes of the object and what is the object. And now we are going to discuss how we create an object in class. Declaring the variable of a class type creates an object. You can have many variables of the same type, also known as instantiation. Instantiation means what? The creating of the object is called instantiation. So here, once an object of a certain class is instantiated, a new memory location is created for its stored, its data members and code. So when you create the object in a class, so we will see how you create the object. And when you will create the object in a class, what will happen? Simple, the data members, that means variables, and member functions, that means functions, automatically stored into that particular object. So data members and member functions are both stored into memory location. That memory location is nothing but object. Inside of that object, in that particular memory location, this data members and member functions is going to be, that means code, data members and code will going to store inside of a object while we creating object. When it's happened, this process is called instantiation. Instantiated means a particular memory location, adding up the data members and code that inside of the object. This entire process together we call instantiated or instantiation. It will happen in a class while creating of a object. I understand object, it has its own memory location for what? For data members and code of a program. This process is called instantiation. We'll see one example here. You can instantiate many object. You can instantiate many object from class type. Example, circle, circle star, C. So now class item, we have a declared object close the place where are needed because it makes easier to identify the object. We'll see. In object types, while creating the object in a class, before going to see the syntax of a creating object in a class, we will see the types of object. Object types. So here, the types of objects are four. There are four types of objects. First one is external or global object. This object have the existence throughout the lifetime of the program and having file scope. External object is nothing but the object have the existence throughout the life of the program and having the life scope. Life of the program, that means nothing but the external or global object will be there until program will be there. The external object will be there, the lifetime of the external object. Once you create in a particular class, it will be there till the end of, till the program will be closed. The program entire lifetime, this object will be survived. You can use until the program will be there in your computer. This is called external objects. You can use the lifetime of the program. Lifetime of the program, you can use this external object. It means what? When you want to delete the program, or when you want to stop that program, remove that program, so what will happen? Automatically this object, external object, lifetime also will be end. This is the meaning of the till program will be there till the external object will be there. So next one is automatic objects, present and visible only throughout the local scope within the they are created. Automatic are local objects, presented and visible only throughout the local scope. It means what? Compared to the external, the local object, the scope is very less. Scope is very less. It will not cross beyond the local scope. So which they are created. So we will see the scope of local variable also. So compared to the external or global object and local object, so the meaning itself tells us the scope of a global object is more than to the scope of a local object when we are creating. Next one is static object. Static object present throughout a program but only visible within their local scope. This type of static object, we can see it can visible, it can work out in a local scope. Local scope means it will accessible or it will visible or it will be applicable within the boundaries. What is the boundary? Local scope. Some restrictions are there, certain boundary is there. So beyond that, this object will not work out. Last one is dynamic. Dynamic is a lifetime may be controlled within a particular scope. So lifetime may be controlled within a particular scope. So these are four types of objects. First one is a global object, second one is a local object, third one is a static object, and fourth one is a dynamic object. Static and dynamic. So local and dynamic, wherever you want, you can use it in a particular scope. So what will happen when you memory allocation of an object? Memory allocation of object. When you create a object, so what will happen? I already told instantiation is nothing but a memory location. The data members or member functions going to be stored within the object, and this entire process we call instantiation. Instantiation. When you are creating your object, it is nothing but we are creating a location or creating a memory for a object. Look at here, class student, int roll number, char name 20, int marks, student S, colon. So what is the object here? How are we creating object in the class? Simple. class name and object name. A syntax for creating an object in C++, simple. First, class name should be there. And the second one is name of an object. When class name and name of object, what will happen automatically? Some memory location allocated for that particular object. That particular object. Look at here. So now, what is the instantiation? Instantiation is nothing but adding of data members and code to the a particular object. How it's adding? So object going to have the a memory location. Inside of that memory locations, this all data will going to be stored. This process is called instantiation, and this will happen when we creating a object. Now look at here. Here data members are there, code is there, the both are stored in a object memory location. So here the variables, roll number is a variable, name is also a variable, and marks it's also a variable. Now this all will called data members. Where this data number should be stored? Within the object. That means this entire part we can call memory location of a object. So what is the name of this memory location? The name of this memory location as we represented this memory location with the name as, and what is a s? S is a object. S is a object. In this object, this all data will going to store. Now this object can access all this data. It's nothing but all this data members. When it wants, it can call. When it access, it can access. It can access. It will happen when we creating an object. When we creating an object, this process is called memory allocation of object. Memory allocation of object. Look at here, how you create object in a class. How you create object in a class. Once a class has been declared, we can create variables of that type of by using that class name. Similar type. So item x, memory for x is created. Item x comma y comma z. So what happened? Once a class has been declared, we can create a variables of the type using the class name. For example, item x and item x comma y comma z. So another way is there. Class item, or class item, and ... close that curly braces, and x comma y comma z. These two ways are to creating a object. What are here? X, y, z. What are here? So creating a objects. These all are kept what? Objects creation. So here. Now how to access data members, how to access that data member? Simple. Object dot function name. Object dot, what is object dot? Means object name dot function name. For example, here x is the object. Previously item x, we create a item space x. What happened? X object is created, and item x, y, z, and three objects are created. So So class name and object name. So when you mention the class name and object name, so how many objects names you mentioned continuously after declaring of this class, that many objects we can create, that many objects you can create in a programming language. So item x, one object created. Item x comma y comma z, three objects are created. The same manner, look at here, how to access once object created, variables also created, and how we access these variables through this object, and how to get the data. Simple, data, want to access it, object name dot function name, object name dot function name. So look at here, object name dot function name, what is the name of the object? X is the name of the object. Net get data is the name of the function member or member function. It's the name of a member function. So object name dot function name, function name. X is the object and get data is a function name. Put the x there, the put data s dot put data. So also a function name. So x dot number equal 100. So it's not possible. S dot number equal 100. It's not possible. It's illegal. Okay. So through the object name dot function name, or we can access the class members. You can access the class members.